What it do, YouTube? KPFPS here, coming back at you today with my E-League 2018 Boston Major Pick'em predictions. Let's get right into the video. Alright, so for those of you who haven't seen the new Major format, they actually added in this stage called the Prelims, which is basically the old Major qualifier. So that means they expanded the Major from 16 teams to officially 24 teams. So what that means for the Pick'em Prediction Challenge is that there are now three stages to it, which include the prelims, the group stage, and the playoffs. And at each stage, you have to pick all your teams at once. You cannot pick any games along the way. You have to pick them all before the matches start, and then the predictions lock. So you actually can't change anything once the matches start for that stage. With that said, here's my picks for the Pick'em Prelims. My first pick for a team that's going to go 3-0 is going to be pretty obvious. It's going to be FaZe Clan. If you need me to explain why, basically they're the number two team in the world right now. I don't think anyone else has a different team here besides FaZe Clan. They're just really, really good. I don't see any world in which they don't shit on all the teams at this prelim stage. Moving on to the team that goes 0-3, a lot of people here are actually picking Quantum Bellator Fire or Avangard, the two teams that came from the Russian qualifier or minor. But I'm actually going to go off the beaten path here, and I'm going with Tai Lu. And my reasoning for this is, A, Tai Lu has Peacemaker, who's a coach, and even when he played, he's not that good. Just look up Peacemaker, train, fail. He's like behind the schools on train and couldn't even kill a guy that's planting the bomb. He's just really, really bad. He said on Twitter that he doesn't want to play at all. There's a language barrier between him and the Chinese players. Then on top of that, they have Bondic, who's Ukrainian. So you have a Ukrainian, a Brazilian, and three Chinese on one team. I think even with raw skill, they're not going to be able to win a game. Because you have Peacemaker, who's going to be an anchor. Five people who know three languages combined. Like, it's a shit show, man. I don't know why more people aren't picking Tai Lu with all the stuff going on in their team. Because Quantum, Bellator, Fire, and Avangard, at least all of them know the same language. They've been playing together. They come from the same country. Like, that's a team, okay? Tai Lu is just a fucking circus right now. So I don't know why people are thinking Tai Lu's going to win a match or go out, but I'm going with Tai Lu, and that's why. Now, the remaining seven teams that will advance are the prelims. My first pick for this is going to be G2. I'm picking G2 because they're top 10 team in the world, the quote-unquote French super team. They should have no problems handling winning three best-of-ones in the pool of teams at this stage of the major. Second pick is going to be Cloud9. I think that's also pretty solid, pretty obvious. They're the number one North American team. Although I believe they have their flaws, and that may be shown at later stages of the tournament, they should be able to make it out of this stage no problem. My third pick for the team that will advance out of the prelims is going to be Na'Vi. I know Na'Vi hasn't been exactly solid, and you know, the super team that they used to be and everyone thought of them as. And Zeus hasn't had a positive event at LAN since rejoining Na'Vi, but I think with their raw skill and, you know, their experience, they should easily be able to make it out of this 16-team pool. And that's why I'm going. My next pick for a team that will advance out of the prelims is actually going to be Space Soldiers. I know that comes as a surprise to some people, but I really thought about, like, who performs on LAN when they needed to most, and Space Soldiers is the team that stuck out in my mind. For example, like winning the EU minor and taking a map off SK at ESL1 Cologne, and also having a close game against Optic. I mean, they really show up on LAN because they play on fuck dick internet in Turkey all day. Like, they've been constantly tweeting and posting forums and fucking Reddit pages about how bad their internet is in Turkey, yet they still qualify for events somehow, and when they go to the events, they actually show up. And that's why I think, like, Space Soldiers, they're not going to come all the way out to this major to fucking lose, okay? They're going to have a really good mindset. They're playing on LAN, so, you know, internet does not even a factor. And that's where they really prove themselves. And that's why I'm going with Space Soldiers, because they've proved to me that they are a good team on LAN. The next team that will advance out of the prelims is going to be Mouse Sports. I think that's pretty obvious. Runner-up at ECS. They also won ESG Mykonos. Sorry if I'm butchering that name. It's fucking Greece. So really good showings, really good team. You know, solid. They got Ropes, Oscar, Sunny. They're going to do some work at this tournament. I think they're going to go out 3-1. Maybe if it gets risky, they'll go out 3-2, but I think that's a 100% pick that they'll make it out. Last two, the next team that will make it out of the prelims is going to be Sprout Esports. I'm going with them because they're 3/5 of the old Penta roster, and on top of that, they added God, Dennis, and Speedy. They didn't have a good result at the Krakow Major itself, but they did well in the major qualifier, and you have to remember that the prelim stage, quote-unquote, is basically the major qualifier. They just changed the name of it. So they've been making it out of the major qualifier. I don't see why they wouldn't do it again, especially with the additions they added. I don't think they're as good as HS and Sunny, but they're definitely solid. They're not bad players in the slightest, especially when you got God Dennis. That's nutty. The last team that will make it out of the E-League Boston 2018 Major is going to be Misfits. Now, I know some of you might think I'm crazy. You might be like, KP, pull your head out of your ass. What are you doing, kid? And, you know, in an alternate universe, I might agree with you. But just hear me out why I'm picking Misfits, okay? First of all, they're the 13th team in the world, according to HLTV rankings. Now, I know rankings don't really mean shit, but they have been on a steady climb, okay? And coming off their recent result at ESL Pro League, I think they're on fire right now. If they play like that, this major qualifier should be fucking slight work, as long as they don't run into, like, FaZe or G2. I mean, hell, I think they could even take down Cloud9 and, like, Na'Vi. You know, Sean Garris is a fucking mastermind. And compared to teams like Envy, I think Misfits would just do circles around them. I don't know, I think Envy is just really not a good pick. I mean, you could substitute Space Soldiers or Misfits for Envy, I guess, and that would be fine. But to be honest, I don't think Envy has what it takes to make it through. The competition's just gotten, you know, really competitive, and Envy's kind of fell behind. I mean, RPK is a tank, Scream's really good, but, I mean, how much can two guys carry what team, you know? Anyways, that's my E-League Boston 2018 prelim predictions. I'll be back with two more videos for the group stage and the playoffs. If you agreed with my predictions, if you disagreed with my predictions, please let me know down in the comments below what you ended up picking. If you went with my picks, you know, prayers to Gaben, you know, may the Lord do us right. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to slap that like button, hit that subscribe button. It would really help me out. But yeah, I'll be back for the next two videos as soon as the prelim stage is over. Hope you guys enjoyed. Peace!